Hello everybody, Prowl here, and today we are doing a car review. Right now you will notice we're in an Abarth, an Abarth 500. Yes, it's that small little bug freaking looking car thing, but we're still doing a review on it. I mean, yeah, I shouldn't take it seriously, but hey. Anyway, what's powering this thing, you might ask? Well, it's a 1.4-liter four-cylinder turbo, making 160 horsepower at 5,500 RPM and 170 pound-foot of torque at 2,500. Now, it's a front-wheel drive, so I'm not expecting much, but at least it's manual. So, let's give her a few revs. Oh yeah. That definitely sounds like power. Alright. All joking aside, let's get started. So, let's put it into first. Slowly release the clutch as we launch. Considering the amount of power it has, it actually seems fairly snappy. I mean, yeah, it does have some understeer, but that's to be expected. It's front-wheel drive. Oh, kind of overcooked that shift there. Yeah, definitely does have a little bit of understeer, but it's not too bad. Could definitely be worse. Start turning there. Okay, yeah, it definitely shows its lack of power in these straights, which is fine. I'm not even gonna hit fifth gear, am I? But, yeah. Yeah, it's not gonna be fast, like, what do you expect? Like, it's a freaking Fiat. It'll probably, blow up its engine soon anyway. Let's be real here. Cause Fiat, heh, haha. Fix it again, Tony. However, since it is front-wheel drive, it's fairly easy to drive without, losing traction in the rear. However, I find, oversteer more fun to correct than, understeer. However, considering it only has 160 horsepower, it's a four-cylinder, it's actually decent fuel economy, I think it's actually pretty good. But reliability is almost certainly a concern if you were to get this in real life. Which is why I'm doing it in a sim racing game, because I don't have to worry about that. Typical Fiat problems. I mean, there's a reason why some call it Fix It Again Tony. However, let's downshift a bit. Yeah, definitely understeering quite a bit. Front wheel drive though, so can't really complain. Oh, yep, here we go. Wait, why was I in that gear? Yeah, that one was my bad though. However, it's actually not too bad. Like, it's still somewhat fun, but I most certainly would take, like, an older RX-7 or something. Something rear-wheel drive that's around the same price used. because those tend to be a lot more fun because rear-wheel drive, but that's my personal opinion. But yeah, I think we'll do one more lap because we actually do have another car we will test here at Tsukuba Circuit, which will be probably a tuned-up version of this. Oh yes, this game has that. So we'll see how it compares. I'm actually driving with one hand at this point. That's this car for you. It really doesn't take much to drive it. Which, honestly, is a tiny bit boring. Our final lap. Okay. Now let's get to the tuned up version. And we are back with the tuned up version. This one, it doesn't really do much. Like, it gets us up to 175 horsepower and 181 pound-feet of torque, but other than that, it's nothing crazy. Like, it's not much, but we'll see how it does, because an increase in power is still an increase in power. Revs up a little quicker, that's for sure. It's a fully released clutch, and let's launch. Alright, first impression, still a bit understeery, but that is, of course, because it is a front-wheel drive, so I can't knock too much off it. However, considering it's a front-wheel drive, it's not too bad in the understeer department. Yeah, definitely, you can definitely feel the understeer in those very tight corners. That's where the front wheel drive is very noticeable. Also kind of in these high speed corners you notice it as well. But again, it's front wheel drive, I can't really complain about it. Huh. Interesting. Due to the increase in power, in some corners you actually start wheel spinning. It feels, at least it sounds like wheel spin. And again, that's because it's front wheel drive as well. That doesn't help matters whatsoever. However, it's a lot better to wheel spin in a front-wheel drive than to wheel spin in a rear-wheel drive. Why? Because rear-wheel drive, if you start wheel spinning, you're usually going to start drifting, and if you don't know how to correct a drift, you're not going to be having a good time. However, in a front-wheel drive, it's a lot easier for beginners, because in a front-wheel drive, all you do is understeer. Which is like, hey, let off the throttle a bit. It's like a little warning. Not as serious as a rear-wheel drive if you were to start applying too much throttle. But I still wouldn't recommend it, because you're just going through your tires a bit more. But that's just my opinion, man. Like, it's whatever. Okay, start turning. Yeah, it's... Let's be honest here, it's not gonna be the fastest thing in the world. Like, if you thought it was going to be a very fast, like, supercar grade level performance, I actually kind of feel sorry, but... all in all, I'd say it's, pretty good. I think after this we'll do one more lap, and then we'll cut to, the actual timed run, and, give you the results on that, and, yeah, I'll go into my, final conclusion with them as well, after the timed lap. Which will not have voiceover at all because, well, they're timed laps, but I will at least put music in there. Because music's fun. I actually quite like music. Of course, it's probably gonna be some anime music. Let's be real here. If you've watched this channel enough, you'd know. But then again, we're in an Italian car, so I might change it up a bit. So, we'll find out here momentarily. However, for now, here's the last corner. Alright. Alright, and there we go. Alright. Well, now let's get into the time attacks. Thank you. Alright, so you just saw the two hot laps. They weren't that great as far as hot laps, in my opinion, but I mean, they worked. That's the most important part. But now on to the results. For the stock Fiat 500 Abarth, we had a 1 minute 15.326, which is actually all right. But then again, we haven't done much testing here, so we can't really say for sure. As far as the step one upgrade, which was upgraded horsepower and torque slightly, we had a 1 minute 15.291, and that could be because of my miss shift. But yeah, I'm pretty sure even if I didn't do that, it wouldn't be much better. Anyway, if you like this, please do leave a like, a comment, subscribe to my channel. Hopefully, I can get a better mic soon. And yeah, I'll see y'all later.